Yeah, good evening, YouTube. So my second HD Home Run Network TV tuner showed up today. This was a used unit off of eBay. And pretty simple. It's got your RF connector for your TV antenna, 100 megabit Ethernet plug, and a 5-volt coaxial power jack there. It is made by Silicon Dust, the HD Home Run. It's a dual ATSC, which is over-the-air TV in North America, and then it also does QAM, or QAM, which is the North American cable TV tuner interface. And this is just like the one I have. There we go, HDHR3 US model, made in Taiwan. I looked up the date codes inside. This one was probably made in 2011, so 5 years old. I think I bought my other one in 2013, so I figured get the same vintage. But I wanted to take a look inside, because when I got my first one, I took it out of the box, plugged it in, and it's been on 24/7 ever since that time. So there's just two little screws, and that's what's inside of one of these. Maybe we can zoom in a little bit. You've got your power over here, your outgoing Ethernet, and this is your RF connection. And if we look down here, kind of neat with the, looks like they have like a sort of a ground plane running around there. They don't have a box over the RF, but they have it heavily isolated there. It's probably on a separate ground plane. Looks like there's a separate voltage regulator right down there for the analog section. You've got your incoming cable, goes through, looks like a little transmission line arrangement. There's probably an RF buffer amplifier right there, and you can see it splits into the two tuners. I can't find anything on these chips. They're like WXL201RF, I think is the part number. They're really hard to read. They're probably just some sort of a front end for these two guys. So these are the two DRX3933J demodulators for the 8VSB, which is the ATSC format, or QAM, which is the cable format. So here's your two TV tuners. And then the signals go over here to this guy, which is a IP3017 media and internet processor. You've got a 4 megabit CMOS flash memory up here. These are the two tuner LEDs, so one or the other will light up if one of the tuners is busy, and that's your power LED. And then over here, so you come out of your processor, you've got a Realtek 10100 megabit LAN chip, pretty similar to what you'd have on a PC LAN card. And then here's your incoming DC power here. There's a layered common mode choke, so they put some effort into cutting down any EMI getting out of here into your power supply, which is a little wall transformer you plug in here, 5 volts, 1 amp. And they've got a couple of probably buck converters, step down to, I imagine this guy is probably 3.3 volts, and a couple of crystals. This one says 10, I assume 10 megahertz, but that's pretty low. There must be a step up, because I think this processor runs at something like 600 megahertz. And then this one is a 25 megahertz, probably for the Realtek chip. So that's about all that's in there. There's almost nothing on the back side. Here's your RF section here. You can see all the plated through vias, and everything's pretty much isolated there. Got a couple of traces there. Heavy ground plane. It looks like that's right under those two. Those two chips have heavy pads under them, as do those two. So you get two pads, some decoupling caps, and other than that, the backside's pretty empty. So that's all there is to one of these HD Home Runs. They do have new version. There's a version 4 out, so the HDHR4. So this is just a dual tuner. So you plug in your TV cable and you plug in Ethernet. You get a Ethernet stream with up to two TV data streams, and you can run that into something like DVB link. So I'm going to be plugging this in to my network. So this model is hardwired only, and then they have two new models. I think they're called the HDHomeRun Connect and the HDHomeRun Extend. They both have additional processing inside because they can do the H.264 transcoding, and they also, I think, have Wi-Fi support, and they also have the DLNA streaming, so you actually have a more functional tuner. It's not just a TV tuner, it's actually a kind of a stripped down media server. I didn't need that because I'm using DVB link to do all of that work. Didn't need that extra functionality. And then the other thing is the new versions, at least one of them has a little 5-volt DC fan inside for cooling, and I just don't like having little tiny things like this with little tiny fans, because those little fans don't seem to last very long. And the problem is, if the fan dies, this little thing overheats and then it fails. So I'll get two tuners with this box, and then I've got two with my other box, so I'll have two of these sitting right next to each other. So that'll give me four simultaneous streams, which is pretty reasonable for running a DVR system. I've been doing that for about 3 years now, and I don't think I've run into any conflicts. I want to see how much power one of these things uses. It says on the power brick that comes with it, you can see there, I think it says 5 volts, 1 amp right down at the bottom. Let's take a look at my power supply, see how much AC power one of these takes.